One of the inevitable consequences of doing something new is mistakes, even failure. Neither of these should worry you much if you look at them the right way. This is Vidiotheque, where every week we try to help companies make the most out of their online marketing. I'm Scott Combs. No matter what new thing you try in any aspect of your business, there will be mistakes. There will be failures. I learned very early in my broadcast career that the real pros didn't make fewer mistakes than me. They simply recovered better than I did. Here's an example you've heard yourself if you've ever watched a newscast. The news person reading the story will stumble a bit and then say the magic words that should have been, or rather, and correct the mistake. It's simple, easy, and most people don't even register that as a mistake. It's fair to say a news anchor bumbling a line in a newscast is less impactful to the TV station than a mistake on, say, your brochure telling the entire world they should check you out on Twitter is to your business. That actually happened to one of our clients, and once they got over their embarrassment, they discovered people who read it remembered it far more easily than if they'd spelled Twitter correctly. Disaster averted. When you decide to commit to a content marketing strategy, all the planning in the world will not eliminate mistakes. Inherent in the act of doing something new is the risk you'll mess it up somehow. And it's the fear of being exposed as a company that makes mistakes that so often causes businesses to choose the status quo. You'll forgive me for pointing out that in a changing marketplace, the status quo is as big a risk as any, maybe bigger. As more and more business moves online, companies that fail to negotiate this change will find themselves at a competitive disadvantage. So, how do you handle the inevitable when it occurs? Well, first off, remember, mistakes are not a commentary on your ability to do your job. They are a manifestation of learning and exploration. Next, figure out what you need to do to fix the mistake. Get creative. This is often where you'll come up with some truly innovative ideas that will set you apart from your competition. Thirdly, do not vilify the mistake or the mistake maker. Mistakes are hard enough without vilification, and the result of condemnation is risk aversion and mediocrity. On the other hand, if you begin to view mistakes as an opportunity for learning, an exercise to make your company better by dealing with them head-on and somewhat dispassionately, you've gone a long way to fostering a more resilient company culture that can adapt and overcome any problem. If you are to succeed at this new way of doing business, you have to embrace the mess that comes along with it. Mistakes are inevitable. Your job is not to prevent them all, it's to figure out how to recover from them. That's the way the pros do it. If you like our stuff, click the subscribe button, then share it with your friends. Leave comments, questions, and more on the blog, at YouTube, or at the email address on the screen. Thanks for watching. Now get out and do something.